Welcome to this episode of Your Property Business, the video podcasts that help you get the most out of your own property business. In terms of the conversations you have with landlords, is there a set of, you know, the most common kind of conversations that you have? Are there misconceptions or misunderstandings or things that aren't quite done as you would recommend them to be done? Have you got a sense of what those, you know, the, I don't know, top three or five kind of things are that you, recommend?
That I recommend?
Or was it too general a question?
I don't know, we'll see how we go. So basically, I think we start at the beginning really. An HMO is a house, a domestic property, that's been changed. I mean, it's the occupancy is changing massively. When you've got sort of a small property that's got sort of maybe 5-6 people living in it, and the properties have been adapted to suit that. Sometimes fire safety can be neglected. You know, a typical example would that be a sort of a small terrace property, maybe, where maybe a living room has been changed into a bedroom. And the safe means of escape has been compromised because of that. That's quite a, you know, massive focus to make sure that the means of escape in properties is sufficient. And I do go to a lot of properties where sadly it isn't, and that's not because the landlords want to not keep their tenants safe. Maybe they just don't realise. You know, sometimes it's a, you know, they can turn around and say, you know what, they've got a kitchen, you know, they've got a rear door to the property, they can get out of there safely, but that might be through a risk room. So that's probably the biggest thing I see sort of neglected, really, and maybe not even just not considered, to be honest.
I think that's, isn't it? There's so much in the sort of the property industry, let alone sort of the fire aspects of it, is that you don't know what you don't know. And you know, that's no excuse, really. So I think for me, part of what I want to get listeners and viewers to see out of this conversation is that it's kind of okay not to know, but you kind of, it's not okay not to ask. You kind of need to ask. That's what I would say. So you don't need to know the answer, but you need to know someone who does. I think.
I think that's the thing, isn't it? I mean, it's going to somebody who's actually got that sort of specialism, if that makes sense. It's okay being a fire risk assessor, and it's okay, you know, having qualifications and et cetera. But if you don't know the ins and outs of a certain type of property, it's very easy to miss something that's important. That's why I've focused a lot. I mean, with yourself, I've focused a lot with HMOs, and it's become a bit of a sort of a specialism of ours, really. Just making sure that everything's right and that we're not missing stuff. I mean, I don't like to downbeat other assessors at all, because it's you know, it's not really my style. But I have sort of come across assessments previously where you think, you know what, like, really, you know, as much as I don't like to criticize other people's reports or anything, but sometimes things do sadly get missed that shouldn't be.
I guess you just need to stand by your own sort of convictions and process, really. So if it, you know, if it hits your standard, then that's great. If it doesn't, it doesn't, and that's just a simple reporting back to the landlord and making sure that's clear, I guess.